Welcome back, connoisseurs, to Cognac Corner, recorded in historic Sula, Missouri. Go follow AFM on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Rate us and review us from wherever you get your podcasts and YouTube. Give us 5 stars. If you only give us 4 stars, I must assume you are the goddamn ops, and we don't do that around here. Nope, we don't. I'm going to give you motherfuckers a round of applause. Nope, but guess what?
You're done.
That's what you goddamn done. On Cognac Corner, we have extraordinary conversations with ordinary people about love, sex, relationships, all fueled by cognac. Round of applause for cognac. Thank you, Frenchie, for making this cognac. I am.
Come on. It's the podcast daddy.
I am.
All right, podcast daddy.
And when you say
podcast daddy, come back.
Come back, podcast
daddy. I said, well, I guess I should. I am Marcus Onesimus Boston. Welcome to the mob. And we have a special co-host this evening on Cognac Corner. Deonne Moore of Art by Deonne is back in the motherfucking building.
Hey. It's your neighborhood artist.
Say it again.
It's your neighborhood artist.
And we have new connoisseur to Cognac Corner, Ricardo Swait. I get that right?
Yeah, yes,
all right, woo! Woo! Give me the white man, woo! Give me the white man, woo! All right, how's everybody doing? All right, we all made it. We made it. We're here. We've accomplished something today. Woo! Wow, I'm happy to be here, guys. So the topic for today is, why do we love the soul? And when I say that, I mean it in the way of the human soul and also tennis shoes. Sneakers. I'm unfortunately sized out of tennis shoes, and also finance wise, I don't match. I wear 15, so like it's just
I'm
a lot of
14. So.
Yeah, it's I can't. I have a wide foot, so not only is it 15, it's wide. So now I'm like, hey, Jordan 1's hurt my feet after a while because that shit is just the leather don't go right. But I can't be doing this. Who lives like this? I have some ones that I wear very, very rarely because they might hurt after a while. But
I some 11s.
I just put his breakfast stop.
Some, bro.
I just wear some Crocs and just some Birkenstocks, and she kind of love me for me. There will be no shoes in this house. Some slides. That's we got them Eastlands. So the first we start off on the Cognac Corner is the week that was. So give us the good and bad of the previous week, if there is any good and bad of the previous week. Deonne, you go first, then I'll close it out.
You go first.
God damn, man. It's co-hosting shit. We got to work on this.
Example.
So, okay, example. I'll go first. Good part of the week. So Monday, I went to Cecil does a cornhole blind draw tournament in Soulard. So cornhole is like the bags. You see white people throwing with the wood board and shit, like the those. You look like you've never seen it a day in your goddamn life. All right, so.
I don't know what you thought I was.
It is an outdoor game that you do in the backyard.
I know what it is.
Okay, so he runs that tournament on Monday. And so I was like, cool, let me come down and do like a live show and see what, you know, see what it is. And it turned out really well. Like, it was fun. It was almost like watching like Monday Night Football. We commentate on cornhole. Like, it's some cold motherfuckers. Like,
really?
Yeah, because I don't know shit about it. So I'm just learning, asking questions. I have people around me that actually is involved that can break it down like that. So that motherfucker's doing this. He gonna slide this. I blocked it. Then the motherfucker went over the top. I say, dog, I was just sitting like this. I'm just keep drinking. This shit is amazing. Like, this is, well, I can give me a black team in here. I can find my guys. Hey, we gonna be Deshaun back in the 2000s, bro. We come in and run this cornhole shit.
You went to Deshaun.
No, but I knew some people that did. I didn't go. I knew some people that did. And I would come down and watch basketball. Ooh, this shit's great. Back to the county. Woo, shit. That was adventurous. But anywho, it was a good time. And so I enjoyed that. That was Monday. I go to Nashville on Friday. These are the good things of the week. Okay. I got new books in this week. So that's I like
just
getting new
one
books.
Or many?
I got 3 new books.
Okay.
I like to read multiple books
at
the same time.
One good and or many good.
Whatever the amount of goods you want to share. Whatever much sharing you want to share. I'm oversharing.
Okay, yeah.
Clearly. Yep. All right. So that was the good of my week. The bad is Deonne cut me off saying I'm having too much of a good week and oversharing. That's what I heard. She didn't say none of that. That's what I heard. So I'm in therapy as we speak.
Okay.
All right. Your turn now, Deonne.
I'm sorry about that. It's fine. Okay. So we're going to do one good and we're going to do one bad for me. All right. Okay. It's been one hell of a week already. So we're going to just go with the bad. The bad is they're trying to serve me court papers. He said it's bad. It's bad.
For what?
Right.
What is for what?
Custody again.
Oh, shit.
Just irritating.
Oh, man.
Yeah, my nerves are bad. Oh, it is a good. I got my lineup for my birthday party. Okay. I forgot.
Yeah. Oh, okay. All right. My bad, kind of bad. It is sad. Bad,
bad, bad. Oh, let me get my drink. Oh, no.
No. I feel bad already.
I mean, my brother died.
This week?
Yeah, he died. Yeah. Like Friday or something.
Oh, man.
So that was kind of sad. Mm-hmm. And then I was in that Brock Seals art pancakes and mimosa, so that was good. Like, you know, that was something I had to push through to get even do it, because I was about to say fuck it, you know what I'm saying? Uh-huh. You know what I mean? But I and that was really my first time really transitioning to canvas, so you know what I'm saying, it was you know, something I had to do.
Yeah. You gotta go through to get to it.
Yeah, for sure.
You gotta go through to get to it.
You know. But I pushed through it, you know what I'm saying? It was a good experience for me, and I dedicate that to my brother, so I'm good.
I'm glad.
It was your little brother or older bro?
Nah, see, he way older than me. He was 53.
Oh, man.
That's tough. My age. Good Lord.
Your mama 53?
52. My mama 50.
You?
8.
I mean, never mind. That's it.
Okay. Nah, I'm 35.
Oh, your mama, young.
Yeah, my mama 57. Okay. My husband 40.
That's some young moms.
Yeah. Man,
so get it in at a young age.
I'm going to tell you one thing I heard on Ricky Smalley's show, because his grandmother had passed while he was like out working.
Uh-huh.
And his grandma had always told him, don't ever stop working for me if I'm gone, because I'm already gone.
Yeah, that's right.
Make sure you get that money. Yeah, come stop for the funeral. But make sure you continue to progress and move forward.
Yeah, you know. Got to, though. Like, life gonna happen, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Mm-hmm. You're gonna lose people and things, but you gotta
keep pushing.
Can't let it break you, you know what I mean?
Keep pushing.
So,
you got it. You prime example. You doing
it. Yeah, for sure.
Mad respect for you, dog.
I'm in the depth of the movie, dog.
No, that's real life, man. That's part of the journey.
Getting older, and that's what's gonna happen. No matter what, we're gonna keep on facing. They're gonna be at the door all the time.
Some days come, man. I said, I'm an adult in my family. I said, I should not be in charge. You said, wait a minute. I said, oh shit. Y'all look for me to lead some shit. Y'all in the 60s and 70s. I said, oh shit, auntie, uncles, and y'all. I hope y'all ain't going nowhere soon, because I'm not being charged. Give it to Silver Stinky. She got kids. She might be more responsible with some shit. I can't do it. I'm not built for it. Just tell me where I gotta be. I'm not here. That's why I chose not to be nobody's father, because I'm not built for it. All right. And we're going back. So that was the week that was. Now this is a segment of the show where we put it on our tab. So this is part where we share our socials, our events, you know, where we're doing our next shows at, what's coming up, look forward to, all that stuff. So this is all about you pushing and promoting your things and make sure we make it as special and eventful as possible. So, Deonne, do you need to go second again? Or can you go first now?
Keep playing with me. Okay. I just needed an example, but that was cute. Yeah, I finally started my live since we're past the bullshit. Okay, playing with you, Marcus. Okay, so social media for me, Instagram, that is going to be Art by Deonne. And for Facebook, it is Your Neighborhood Artist. I do have a few events that I am participating in that are coming up. The first one is, what do I got coming up? You might have to come back to me because I didn't forget. Poetry down at the Legacy. That is on the 17th. No, 27th. Yeah, I'm going to put the flyer up when I got it. I am so sorry. I do got a fashion show or collaboration that is coming up in September. Paint Louis is in September as well. And I have one other event that I have forgotten about. So we'll come back to that one and look out for additional art, of course, always. Now this is my song.
Ricardo, this is your spotlight.
Facebook, Ricardo Feetby Swait. Instagram, Feetby Swait, FeetbySwait. And the same on TikTok. I need to get my TikTok. I need all my followers up. Facebook, I'm good. Okay, okay. And I ain't got a lot going on. Well, I'm actually going to be now at the... like taste of St. Louis with my girl in September. Man, I really been just trying to formulate some ideas and try to get myself out there a little bit more. So I just keep people posted, but you need some customized, hit me up. Right on Feetby Swait. That's all I got.
So how long have you been like doing your art publicly? Like when actually like showcasing what you've been doing?
You saying like...
I guess you should say your first art show was this past weekend, right?
Yeah.
So before that, what was your... So you've been always customizing shoes and
yeah,
like...
it's just really mainly social media. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, but it's been about 4 years.
When you started high school?
Yeah, I just started 4 years ago.
Oh, shit.
Man, y'all, he the dopest custom shoe maker in St. Louis. Like, hands down, I would have been thinking you've been doing that way longer.
I just told you, I just started tapping into these abilities, man. I probably went maybe a decade and didn't draw nothing, honestly, man. Like, something I've been sitting on. So that's why when I hit you up, I'll be asking questions and, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm still learning, you know what I mean? So I'm just learning as I go along, for real.
Man, the sky's the limit. I can tell you that. If you already heard, it's infinity and beyond after this.
Right,
trust and believe. I gotta look. Hey. I gotta send you an invitation to my birthday party. I just got the lineup done. I'm sorry, I'm being real ghetto on your shirt.
We going to the, hey man, you know what? This show ain't about me no more. I just show up to
this podcast.
Hang with my friends. So that was put on our tab. So that was everybody's socials, events coming up. That's where I don't have anything right now, guys. I'm thinking about doing like a Uno. I want to do like a Uno, like World Series of Poker on ESPN shit. I want to do like a Uno night, like this Uno tournament, and we just do a podcast, Uno shit. Like I think we're doing it in August. Like I got the location, I just got to figure out the logistics. But like I love Uno. Like I want a Uno champion. I get a big ass Uno championship belt because Uno the shit. What?
I like Uno.
I think Uno's almost a spades game, but nah, fuck that ain't the rule.
I like Uno. Have you played Uno Flip yet?
Yeah, they got all
kind
of Uno.
Yeah, they got shit crazy, man. I got Uno Flip, Uno Attack. I got the Drunk Uno with the shots. I got Waterproof Uno.
That one.
I ain't like white people, so they be fine as shit.
Okay.
Man, the whites undefeated, man. Them motherfuckers work well together. Boy, they fall in line, buddy. They fall in line. It's that thing for the empire. Woo! All right. So that was that part of the show. Man, this cognac kicking in. So I had some shoe questions. So these are some shoe questions I feel we should talk about. What was your favorite shoe growing up?
Favorite shoe growing up? I got two, actually. I love the up tempo. I still wear it right now. Like, up tempo.
The Pippins with the air on the side? Yeah, that came back. That comeback was hard, man. Like I never forget, like, 10th grade. Everybody had on a pair besides me.
I hated it.
And it was the 10th grade or was it 7th grade? I think maybe 7th grade. One of them two. But everybody, all the black people, I had the black and white ones. I was like, everybody, any black person that was dope in school had a pair. I have some New Balance, some gray ones.
Yeah, and I'm in therapy. Nike Dunk, even though I hated
the dunks.
I made the resurgence because I'm not paying $200 for no dunks, bro.
Yeah.
It was always $90, $100, and they never was selling out. So, it's a skateboarder shoe. Yeah. Bro, you know what I mean? But they're my two favorite. Yeah.
Inflation. You have to deal with it.
I mean,
that should be capped. I was like, shit. The regular ones, like, come on, these should not be $240.
The material costs are high now, so it's not the same.
But the inflation part ain't really what bothers me, is that everybody want to wear them now, man. Like, yeah, it was a shoe that nobody, like the Jordan 1, nobody wore them shoes.
I'm mad about that one, because now I can't get my Jordan 1s for the 75.
That's
no more,
my point. Like,
and I can't even get them no more.
That's
I'm just
my point. Like, that's why I said I'm not paying $200 for some Dunks. The retail still ain't even $200.
Man, you about right. Y'all telling y'all age, though. Y'all 40 knockers. You know what I'm saying?
Wait a minute.
That's why I said 40 knockers. Y'all at the door.
The disrespect
is
hot.
Y'all at the door. I'm just saying, y'all telling y'all age like a mug. I would have hit a Reebok Classic. You hear me?
He wear a 15, I wear a 14.
I know, that's why y'all in the same category. You could have did like the jail sole ones, like the low style.
Nah.
You wouldn't even pull it off a Chuck.
Nah. My feet too big for a Chuck. I don't like being like a Shy Show Bob out here, them big ass Chucks. Nah. Come on, them goddamn Chucks.
You'll be all right.
I look goofy as hell. Big ass boats.
Tempo hella bulky for real.
That's the best of shoe shoe.
Yeah.
All plastic air bubble.
Hey, you lost it.
I think my shoes was the Air Max 95s.
You like 95?
95 is my favorite. Okay. All day. And the Griffies. Okay, not the ones that turn that crazy lace shit. The ones right before, maybe the fours or three. Those are my favorite shoes. I never had a Griffies. I had a bunch of Air Force Ones. I had all the 95s of all the colors. And then I always wanted the Griffies. I never could find them. Of course, I got was the crazy looking crazy ones. I said, these ain't the same ones. It's not McDonald's. Like Griffies, but then that the Griffies that was the one that came back out recently. It wasn't those. With the 24 on the side? No, it was the ones after that. It ain't the same.
Okay, I got a counter question. So which shoe do you like to customize the most?
I customize mostly Forces, but I feel like shoe. I like the high top Force, honestly.
More space.
But I never get none, but top joint, it's like way a bigger canvas, you know what I'm saying? I did a Chuck though, like a high top leather Chuck. Yeah, that was
cool. Leather?
Yeah.
Okay.
High top leather joint. Like it's like a canvas, yeah.
For real.
You got it. Them low top Forces so tedious.
They are.
Low top Forces, man.
That's all they get. That's what they want customized. I like doing the kids. I ain't even gonna lie.
I hate doing the kids.
It's on the little kids shoes.
Oh, you said the kids.
Yeah, because they clock. And it go real fast. It's like it's wham bam, thank you, man. You put on the pencil on and all that. Cloth way better than leather. Degloss them or nothing. You know, you go straight to work.
What was your favorite shoe store?
Right now?
Now and then.
Kids Foot Locker? Still.
Okay, she don't count. Go ahead, dog.
Honestly, bro.
Little ass feet. Disrespectful.
Right now, I don't have a shoe store because I just...
Ain't no shoe... Where is the shoe store?
Like, it's pointless to go to a shoe store, man.
Yeah.
You're not getting nothing good. So, I literally only buy Blazers and Air Force Ones right now because the only thing I don't got to pay an extra fee for. So, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Back in the day, our soul was the... the spot, like in the
loop.
The loop, man.
Yeah. And what was the other one? Was the one further up? Yeah, Foot Lock on that side, and the further up was shit. I used to go in there all the goddamn time with that damn shoe store. It was like a sporting goods store, but it had that back section that was tennis shoes.
Oh, I know what you're talking about too. Yeah.
Damn, I can't think of that name right now. Fuck. I know golly. Boy, we have lived some lives.
My spot, man.
Ah, man. I think mine was Foot Action. I was getting some 95s in there on my size. Forgot about them. Sports. Foot Action was the one.
Street Legends, too. Was.
Yeah. Yeah.
It was the good days, man.
I could always go to Kids Foot Locker, though, when I was younger.
Yeah. Yeah. And rent it up. Yeah.
Champs is really good, though.
Cheating. What's the worst shoe ever?
Anything Balenciaga make.
You ain't never lie. I've never tried them on, but I just heard bad stories about them.
Anything Balenciaga make. This is
anything Kanye make. Anything Kanye make. I'm
Balenciaga over. Is disrespectful to the culture, man. It's like I'm finna just throw some shit out here, and I'm and put $1,000 on it. People gonna buy.
I said you get the fuck out of your thick ass soul ass shoes. I mean, I said, why are we doing this? Why you want to play with us, guys?
$1,000 Skechers, man.
Yes,
that's what you just said. But they don't fit like Skechers. Skechers feel real good. They real comfortable. You hear me? I done wore them before. Them mugs feel like heaven.
Anything I could do, man. They are horrible.
You right.
What is the most overhyped shoe and the most slept on shoe?
Well, the Air Jordan 1s used to be slept on and now they not no more.
And they woke up.
They not even overhyped. They comfortable in everything.
Not a foot wide.
Overhyped shoe. Balenciaga. Fuck it. Let's keep this a Balenciaga. What's the shit that everybody wear?
Vans. They kind of overhyped. They ain't comfortable.
Can't think of the one shoe everybody be wearing. It's like a Alexander McQueen.
Mm.
I don't know nothing about them shoes, y'all.
Nerf shoes.
I don't know nothing about this, y'all.
Slept on shoe. Alexander.
I just bought a new pair of Reeboks. I bought another pair of Chucks.
New Balance really now slept on. Like I've bought some.
Slept on no more.
Oh, shit. Maybe
they ain't nothing slept on no more.
Yeah, for real. Right. I'm sorry.
I think they still sleep on them classics though. But them New Balances. I don't know what happened. I went to the store, got my daughter a pair. They all was gone the next day.
Damn. Yeah.
Just like Tommy. I felt like I brought Tommy Hilfiger back. For real.
I was big time back in the day. My favorite Tommy outfit was I finally got a pair of them fucking overalls. Tommy overall with Tommy right there. Tell me shit the day at school. They gonna tell me nothing. Everybody was on the menu that day. I was walking to school with the shits. Had a fresh pair of Tims on too. Oh man, I was killing it that day. Anywho. Moving on. Nothing now. Okay. So how do you find the shoe culture and what's your role in it? Shoe culture is weird.
How do you find it? It's a shoe culture?
Yeah, it's big business. It's a culture. I mean, it's definitely a culture to it. Like, an old boy from my old boy was a VP of Nike. Her son was selling like all the shoes off the back of the house with a Nike credit card. I said, you ain't give a fuck.
Do nothing for real.
And do shit. She's like, I've been here for 30 years. I retire now. Yeah. Run me my money. Fuck you, son. Come on home when you get done. I said, well, must be nice.
So ask the question again.
So what? How do you define shoe culture and what's your role in it?
I mean, I just customize shoes. Like, so, you know, I clean. So, you know what I'm saying? That's my role. But honestly, I feel like being a retired sneakerhead, I feel like it's
what made you retire?
I ain't got no plug, man. As I keep stating, I ain't about to pay over retail, bro.
Right.
Like, things like when the masses start, everybody starts to do it, it's just not cool anymore. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? It's mm-hmm. like, back then, it was like a few cats with sneakerheads, like, and they wasn't just on the hype. You know what I mean? Yeah. I like Jason Kidd's and mm-hmm. Penny's and, mm-hmm. like I said, I love Dunks and, you know what I mean? Like, I was a sneakerhead,
bro. I love them KGs, man. Them KGs is hard. I love when I got them blue and black ones.
You know what I mean? So, when everybody became a sneakerhead, it's just not even fun no more. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, I wear flip flops all the time.
Man. They not no true sneakerheads, though, because they ain't finna be naming off none of the shoes. You just name. They go for
one genre. Everybody just wear Jordans for real. Right. I don't even wear Jordans.
That ain't even considered a sneakerhead if you just in one, class.
I feel like you gotta kind of know the history behind mm-hmm. the shoes. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you was talking about your Griffies, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? A real sneakerhead, they got some nostalgia to it, or they...
Them Grand Hills, them fucking Mashburns. Yeah, ooh, my Steph be like, had a run. Yeah. Oh, those Stackhouse, I had those too. Yeah. Man, I had a run with those. I had no joys about everything else. I was the king of the B class.
I feel like...
I was like, we can make good decisions. Make good decisions.
I feel like the real sneakerheads, people who like... They admire certain shoes growing up, but they couldn't afford them, so mm-hmm. they got older. Like, I'm gonna get this. Now these cats ain't struggling. Like, I work at a school. Mm-hmm. When I was in elementary school, we was dirty. Like, in my school, like, everybody was dirty. Some people had them Pro Wings, some people had SJ 900, some people, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
So it'd be the one cat who they parents probably sold dope or something. I was that
one. We all had that nigga together as a unit. Hate this nigga.
Literally, everybody got on Jordans and phone posits and something fresh mm-hmm. now. Like, so they, you know what I'm saying? They don't even understand, like, the struggle for real.
Not at all. One cat at the bus stop, all got a fresh pair. They came out. Yep. There's no way you get these every Thursday. You come with a fresh pair to the bus stop.
That mama worked at Foot Locker.
We hate that nigga.
I wish his mom was on Section 8. You know what I'm saying? You got to think about it for real.
Mom was on Section 8, and their kids got Jordans.
Yep. So, You're right. That's why I stopped being jealous of them. I'm like, your mama don't have to pay no bills. Right.
Okay, that is the end of the shoe questions.
Okay, you know you got 15 minutes to ask these little questions that you're gonna be asked.
Oh, we gotta get to that fish fry. I'm sorry. we got four questions.
I'm past my bedtime. I need to fry my fish still.
Okay, we're gonna get these four quick questions out of here. I'll put them up on the screen. So this is the segment of the show we call Cognac Thoughts. Okay. I feel like we had enough cognac to have these thoughts. This is a little more into the relationship segment of the show. Okay. So, question one:
you finna ask us relationship questions.
After the third date, is it sex or friend zone? Who wants to go first?
After the third date.
Oh, okay. Is that too soon?
Oh, that might be too late. No.
I'm like, after the third date. It depends on how the date was. Most people don't make it past first date with me. So if you make it past first date, you pretty much winning all, maybe. Third date, we out of friend zone. Okay. We can get third.
You know? I mean, it just really depends on the person, too, though. Like, the vibe, you know? Like, sometimes, like, sex is going to happen naturally anyway. You know what I'm saying? So, you might take a girl on 10 dates before you hit, but you ain't worried about it because the vibe's so good. You know what I'm saying?
10 dates. Yeah,
I mean, that's extreme, but I'm just saying, like.
Acting like he ain't hit 10 dates before. Hey. You haven't hit 10 dates before with one person.
What do you mean? We've had 10 dates, but I've hit by date two. Three. We've had 10 dates as a whole, but like, I'm not waiting until 10 dates to get there. My patience is horrible now. I am a horrible, horrible, horrible. I'm sorry.
You need to slow that up.
My patience is bad. like my give a fuck level is ultimate. It's really, really bad. Me and my therapist is really working hard to get me through this. I'm in a bad space. Okay, so the answer to the question for you is, after the third date, is it sex or friend zone? No, because we're going to figure it out about date two. That we were saying. Depends on how the date goes.
For the most part.
Are they?
Yeah, I'd probably friend zone you if I'm keep on hanging out with you and we ain't doing nothing.
Clearly. Yeah, I mean, yes.
I don't know that. I mean, but you speaking for herself. She's speaking for herself, but I don't know. I feel like
people, they different, man. Yeah. Like, everybody has different definitions on, like, what we doing. Like, you pull up, like, for me, like, I include you into my life. My life is hectic. It's not regular 9 to 5. I do a lot of shit. So, like, if I extend an invitation to you, what I'm doing, that's me including you into my life. Then I'll make time for us as I figured it out. Like, don't just say, I met you somewhere, change your life for me. I don't know you, fam. Like, give me some time to adjust my life to yours, because my life is crazy. Your life is 9 to 5. Blah, blah, blah. My shit's not structured at all. Our podcast, my day job, crazy. Blah, blah, blah. Don't think I'm going to stop my life because you jumped in here. No, I'm including you in my life, and then we can figure out where we can do date shit, and blah, blah, blah. Don't be offended. But if you are, is that going to work?
Once you said all that, but if you want some draws, you're going to have to sacrifice something. You need to. Okay, well, let's do the next question. I'm just giving you a little game
now. When the fuck is Russia going to invade America? I'm ready for some shit to pop off, because nothing I do makes sense.
I'm laughing, so don't say that. Y'all, disclaimer, I don't got nothing to do with none of this.
This is a PSA. I have nothing to do with that Boston sir over there. Okay, are we ready for the next question?
Yes.
What was your answer to that first question?
He said he out of the friend zone.
You don't make it to day 3. We're going to know about day 2.
So that's generally, that's I can make it before day 3, but...
Like, we old now. It ain't like we your
home.
I'm
in a relationship now, but...
Ain't no spraying chickens.
I'm in a relationship now, but...
Back in your day. Back in your day.
They might get put in the friend zone or something. You know, you never
right.
know. No one can spread a friend zone. You get what you get. Yeah. Why do women shame submissive women?
Why do women change into submissive?
No, why do shame? Why do women shame submissive women? Like, that question
because
comes...
Because they don't have no man.
Oh, well, there it is.
Why do women shame submissive women? Mm-hmm. Because our women don't need us anymore, man.
Like, nah, man.
No, I'm saying.
I could have been really bad with this answer.
No, you, honestly, though, like.
You got a black woman.
I definitely got a black woman. But, like, see, the thing is, like, we always compare relationships to back in the day. And I didn't analyze this. Back in the day, the 60s, because that's when everybody, the men was.
They love going back to that shit now. They love that, but beating that drum.
You got to think about it, though. Women weren't as successful back then. You know what I'm saying? Like, they didn't have the opportunities back then.
They couldn't get a bank account, can't get a credit card, a whole bunch of, like, legal shit. You couldn't do
back then. You know what I'm saying? And our women are more independent and strong now, so they don't necessarily need us. So you find a woman who is raised by other strong women who it might not have been a man in their household. So the woman's always doing everything. So it's not necessarily normal in our culture anymore. You know what I'm saying? So if you
she don't know how to be a partner. Like, she never been taught or mentored, like, in how to be a partner.
Like,
she used to run and shit because she had no choice.
The woman is the head of the household in the black community now. So it's hard for a woman to be submissive to a man because, like I said, they don't necessarily need them. They needed them back then to survive.
And I don't, the only reason why I say I don't agree to that is because a woman did so much in the home and outside the home. Men, all they had to do was work. And half the time, they wouldn't even get paid enough to take care of the bills.
You don't think so?
No. And a lot of women did work back then too. So you taking care of the house, cooking, cleaning, birthing children, taking care of the children, nursing them, and still going and nursing the white people kids. But you trying to tell me that, oh, I needed a man. Technically, she really didn't at that time. They just were more in sync
and it at was, that point. Like, to be a single mom back then was, like, frowned upon. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, to have just to do, you know, have children out of wedlock.
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm saying people woke up one day and was like, you know what? I'm already doing everything. What do I need them for now? Yeah. Like, she working and she cooking, cleaning, all this stuff. And all you got this man, he want to come home and probably drink and beat you. Because he mad that his life ain't going right. A lot of women men used to cheat. They just didn't make it, like, publicly now. Now everything's just public.
Yeah, I feel you. And I don't say I'm right or I'm wrong or you right or wrong, but I feel like just back then, we had tradition back then. You know what I'm saying? Like, we kind of stood for something back then. And a woman was taught how to cater to a man. You know what I'm saying? Nowadays, it's like you taught, like, and really, in actuality, a man, we created for each other. A woman is created to be the man's companion. You know what I'm saying? So we need each other, but we live in a society that we're taught that we don't need each other.
We think that we don't need each other anymore. Yeah, yeah, you know what I'm saying? And that's the bad part. Because the thing about a submissive woman, if you're a submissive woman, you can get anything from a man. Anything.
My girl can give it up.
I'm trying to tell you.
Hey, leave me alone. I'm not ready. I like my life. Don't seduce me. I YP Valley by myself. That's what I want to talk about.
Don't tell nobody else.
We not finna talk about P-Valley. I don't even talk about that.
Why? I had something I want to get off my chest about that, but I guess I'm up now. Moving on.
I'm tired of seeing this stuff on TV all the time.
So what was the final answer? Why do women shame submissive women? Because they single?
All right.
I think because they single. His was completely different. I think if you shaming somebody, either you single or you just too headstrong. You don't know the benefits of being submissive.
And I have submissive. It's almost spoken out as a weak and work word. Like, submissive is not a bad thing. It's like, if motherfucker Scotty Pippen was submissive to Jordan, motherfucker, it was teamwork, motherfucker. Like, you submissive in a way it works. Like,
in a relationship, both people are supposed to submit.
Yeah, you know, I'm not good at cooking. I'm submitting to your cooking skills. Yeah, I can't do shit in this room.
Yeah, both people are supposed to submit. So, like, it is, I feel like it. People do give it a negative connotation, but then, hey, like, you're supposed to submit. Like,
you're supposed to. Somebody put on my thing, they say, I believe it's ego that does that.
Yeah, we got to dissect ego now. We got to break down that.
It can go deep, though. Everything can go in. People might be afraid to submit because...
It's scary. Being vulnerable is scary as a motherfucker. Somebody, like, let a motherfucker inside as a bitch.
You might have submitted to somebody and they took advantage of it.
Yep.
Man, top all that shit, boy. Now you're in there cleaning up with motherfucking a hand broom. God damn, like glass in here.
But you got to know the signs. Some people walk right into the
clean
warning
through
signs.
Like a nigga, you know, driving down Broadway. Right, red light,
and get
nothing.
Mad when it happened. You know, it blow up. So it's
he ain't gonna do it to me. The fuck he ain't.
Be submissive to the right person. That's all I gotta say. That's like same thing as marrying the right person. Marry the right person.
Believe what they
know
show
you.
Marrying. Believe what they show you. Not what you want to see. Why do women rush relationships?
What? What?
How you follow that up with that?
I am not attacking. Targeted women question.
Why do people rush relationships?
Okay, because I'm like, wait a minute. I done had people told me I'm their girlfriend and I never said that. I done been on one date before and they was like, at the end of this, we together. Like, no, it's not always women.
Do people rush relationships? I'll go first on this one.
Go for it.
I'm going to tell you why. When you live by imaginary clock, biological clock, or you're living on somebody else's standards, not your own, and you're not following the timing of your life, you rush things instead of enjoying how you got here. So, like, smell the motherfucking rose is like this example. So, like, relationships. If I get a relationship with somebody because I wasn't tricked into it, but, like, I occupy my time enough by doing things I want to do or you like. For I know we together now, because, like, I might have been dating multiple women, but you figured out, like, if I want this man to be my man or just I like spending time with him, you are forthright and you make plans for my time. You're fighting for my time. So if I have my time with you because we enjoy each other, I don't have time for them because them is always there. because them is always there. But like how we become more of an important thing are, what are we? What are we? Nothing now. We could have been a whole lot until right now. If you want me to be here, if you want something to progress, occupy my time, before I know it, you are all my time. Or not. I got time to spare. Your turn.
Nine times out of ten, if somebody's rushing something, it's because, like you said, they have this clock in their head where everything has to happen on a certain time frame, mm-hmm. or it's not going to happen at all. But outside of that, I would need to know what rushing is. Some people would think, oh, telling you that y'all in a relationship after 6 months is just rushing. Or telling you, hey, let's be married after 5 years is rushing. You get some people who will think that. And they will tell you that they're rushing along. Like, I'm not going to give no example. I done seen people wait 15 years and be like, why are you trying to get married so quick? Like, it depends. It depends on who 15. The person is and what you consider rushing.
My job. My G.
What is y'all timeline, though? So, what is a typical, because I ask questions like this all the time, and I guess I'm only stuck with, like, a small bracket of people. Mm-hmm. But what is a good timeline for dating and then transitioning into a relationship to where it's like just solely you two, and then progressing towards, you know, engagement, marriage, ordeal?
That's a good timeline. I feel like you got to do what works for you, though. You know what I'm saying?
But just a standard. If we was just going to go with a just flat out standard timeline.
Standard timeline. Okay, so you meet, y'all vibing, then y'all say, okay, we committed. So, okay, for that, maybe a couple months.
Okay.
I mean, you know what I'm saying? If you feel comfortable with that person within maybe 2-3 months.
I was thinking 3 to 6. I think 3 to 6 is a good spend. Like, if I meet you in the summertime.
3 to 6 months to tell somebody that y'all in a relationship?
I'm busy. So, like.
You know, what, you think that's a bad thing or what?
I'm saying I would give. Because I gotta think of the timeline of if you were in school or something. Most people claim a girlfriend probably after 1 week. That's in school. But we adults now.
Right.
If you are continuously dating the same person for 2 months, you trying to tell me you don't want to at least say we're exclusive so that you know that you all are not dealing with other people or having to have any surprises? Would you want them going out and dating somebody else and possibly, you know, beginning a relationship with them? Wouldn't you want some type of stipulation on it?
I think... You can't put stipulations on things like that, though. Like, you know what I'm saying? That got to happen naturally for both people, though. So a stipulation, because once you do that, then that kind of taint things. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to go into something like, you got 3 months to commit. You know
got 90 days, nigga.
Yeah, that's too much pressure on a person.
But just saying that you all are in a committed relationship. 90 days, I think, is really nice.
And I'm a guy who I rush, so I ain't going to even fake it.
I'm just like, I'm not saying marriage or even an engagement. I'm saying flat out, we have an understanding. It's me and you, nobody else. Like, if you see me outside and I'm flirting with somebody else, your feelings gonna be hurt if you ain't want. And then I'm be like, we ain't together. Then your feelings gonna be hurt. So it's better for us just to have that establishment.
Elephant.
You lost your mind. Okay.
So what's yours though? You say
that blew from my face.
What's mine? I would say standard, about 2 months to figure out whether you all are in a relationship or not. At the end, maybe 90 days. If you can't decide within 90 days, all right, I'm dating other people. We'll see where we go. And then by, I would say 2 years in, engagement.
I know. I mean, I agree with all that, though. But, man, you got to go back to people's history, too, man. People went through some stuff, so you can't.
But why should the next person be faulted for what somebody else
did? You got to be sure.
Yeah, you got to be sure.
Don't bleed on me if I ain't cut you.
Because you know, the first couple months is a super honeymoon phase. You know what I'm saying? Everybody, like, vibing, everything good, and then some. They might just go crazy on you.
You break up with girlfriend, boyfriend easily. It's the marriage stuff that you got to wait for. You can break up with somebody easily.
That's right.
So we can be together today. Tomorrow, I'm tired of you.
Yeah, that's right. And that's but that's another reason to not necessarily. I mean, I don't know why I'm saying this because I'm a chronic rusher, but that's a reason. That's a reason not to rush, though. Like, honestly, because it's like, I don't want to waste these months with this person, and then I realize, like, this ain't the person that I thought they were. You know what I'm saying?
This ain't my person.
Yeah, yeah. So maybe that's why you should take a little more time. Sure.
You better rush with me, because, baby, I'm going to be dating everybody under the sun in the meantime, in between time.
I mean,
I'm just saying, I tell people that. So you gonna have, like, I don't rush people.
Down. Well, like 8 boyfriends in a year.
I don't. You can have a boyfriend. Don't mean you screwing everybody. You can even see my thing.
So if you wait 2 months, he ain't work out. I go on to the next guy. I'm with him 2 months. You know what I'm saying? Like, you gonna be to have 4 or 5 boyfriends in a year.
But how do I know I'm not passing up my king to deal with somebody who still can't even tell me whether or not we exclusive? I'm okay with just saying we're exclusive. We don't have to do the whole title stuff. But as long as we have an understanding that we exclusive, we good. If we don't have an understanding that we're not exclusive, then you might catch me outside hanging out with somebody else. Like, one monkey don't stop no show.
Them treacherous out here. Hey.
Shoot, I ain't gonna be. I'm getting older.
I'm
glad I ain't out here.
I ain't out here either.
I'm glad I rushed into my relationship. I got it right this time. I rushed and got it right.
There you go.
All right. Wow. Okay. I'm gonna get 2 more quick ones. Get the fuck out of here, because this is. I'm gonna die like this. Like, I'm happy you found somebody, man. For India. Yeah, right. No, it's outside. It's rough out here.
Well,
bro.
It's plenty of men who know what they want and go for it. Like. The guy I'm with, he went for it. So, my ass in a whole fucking relationship.
You ain't your purpose, bro. That's all that matters.
I'm the problem. I know it's me.
Well, hey. He just said he waits 6 months before he even say that they are in a relationship. And it's because he busy.
Honestly, he focused on the right things.
What?
His purpose. He busy. He got his podcast. He listed all everything he was doing. So... He gotta find a woman who in line with it.
Excuses. That's what Marcus is. Marcus' excuse. I have 3 children, single mother, 24/7. I go to practices, everything, run a business, and do events for the whole city and volunteer work and work my ass off. You hear me? Go to church, Sunday school teacher. When I say you make time for what you want to make time for, and I still entertain my man at the end of the day. Everybody get itched, hanging out with cousins, all that stuff. I don't get no sleep. But that man get my time too.
So I gotta cut my sleep out. I see. So there goes my sleep.
Sometimes when you new relationships, what do they require? No rest.
Will be some sleep.
Is that new relationships?
Yeah. You don't get no rest in new relationships.
So guys, what we learned today was that
You gotta talk about me. I'm trying to help you out. Give a female your time. You ain't gonna be saying
that. What you afraid of, bro?
I don't know how to care enough.
Why you stuttering? Mm-hmm. What you afraid of? Mm-hmm. Who hurt you, bro?
Don't get to crying over her.
You gonna Ray J me out here? That's what you're not gonna do. Ray J me.
I'm like waiting, Minnie.
No, I have not been hurt. I've been very focused on finding my purpose. And I've achieved certain things. And now it's like, I'm quick, like, you know what? I'm going to sleep. I don't know. I guess I don't want it harder. I don't want it enough. Yeah. It's like a lot of work.
It sound like hurt, too.
I ain't been hurt by shit.
Because you gave up on it. Anytime you give up on something,
What year is this? 2022. So 2015, 13.
Yeah, somebody hurt you, bro.
That's her. He's speaking from her. You could hear it in his voice while he was saying.
I dated white girls for 15 years, okay? So I stopped dating white girls at 30. So I'm 37 now. So for the last 7 years, I'm trying to come home. It's been a journey.
Always hard to come
home. I left the white girls alone.
Yeah, it's hard to come back home.
I did your white girls from 15 to 30. I was out here like Jeezy. I had bricks. I was out here moving it. If I was in the streets, we all eating good. I'm talking about we had like the syndicate out here. I was snowman. I say, no, this don't make no sense. I graduated college. I said something. I started reading books and shit. Like, wait a minute. This ain't adding up right. I'm coming home. That's been a fucking journey. We're on year 7.
Transitioning. So being home.
So you just trying to get, just trying to mess with black women.
I'm trying to focus on black women only right now. I'm trying to stay, trying to find my queen in the black community. To keep me safe and feel my soul.
What's the difference, though? I ain't never dated white women. What's the difference, bro?
Bruh, white women. So during my time on cocaine, so set this up so I clean this up later.
Cocaine's a hell of a drug.
I went to Brentwood. I went to a mid-county school in Brentwood.
Okay.
So, like, the black girl wasn't checking for me. They was trying to go to my Sean niggas, both my niggas. They was trying to show out in the hood. Rachel, Meredith. Carly was like, come on over to the house.
Oh, okay.
Drive the car. We got a fridge full of shit. Do what you want to do. So, I was appreciating, not tolerating. So I was like, well, here we are. And I ran it up. I ran up the high scores. But then I got to the top. I was like, it wasn't fulfilling. Like, I was never wanted to stay. I was always ready to leave. Like, this not my house. I'm running it up.
You never been with a black woman?
I sprinkled something in during that time, but I know we're going to be last for long.
Have you been in a long-term relationship with a black woman?
I mean, everyone, no more than 6 months.
You haven't.
Nah. So the unison is like, you have not been there.
You being on the ship no more. It ain't working.
Go, hey, just go where you happy, bro.
I don't know where I'm happy. That's the problem. I'm trying to. No one pressure me. It's the choices I've made for my own, like, peace. Like, I've always had more peace and comfort with black women because I know if some shit go left, we here. We know what the left is. Becky knows what the fuck left. What's going on, guys? Nah, bitch, pull the trigger, nigga. We don't have time to figure this shit out right now. So, like, it was just the cultural comfort change for when I changed.
You just need a hood white girl.
Thank no, you. I've been there and they ain't the same either because she do the most. That's how I call those the dirty bunny. Those dirty bunnies.
Did she call you the N-word?
Nah, we don't play those games.
These men see the dirty bunnies. My stuff is on live.
Oh, shit. Well, god damn.
That was not me.
So I'm just in this, I'm just trying to figure this shit out.
Just hit me up.
Trying to figure this out.
It's fine.
So I guess we came to no conclusion for that question, guys. I don't know.
Black people do keep you safe.
I'm trying to figure it out. I'm just trying to figure out.
Yeah, because he clowning on here, y'all.
I have no idea. I just have no idea. Now it's like, my patience is short. Only thing I can't do is cook, but like everything else I can do for myself. So what are you here for?
You get your ass on that dating website.
That shit corny. I've been there for too goddamn long.
Don't say that. My
shit crazy. My profile bitch is nuts. My Mr. Fuck Them Kids is probably not the best headline.
Yeah, don't do that. You better trust them. Them sites is there for a reason because it's hard to go out here and find somebody now. Somebody said no raisin. Bob, you funny. No raisin and a potato salad.
Thank you. Let's move forward. All right. Why do men wife hoes? Anybody anything?
Why is that a question?
Where you come up with these questions?
Why is that a question? Where is that question coming from? I don't even understand. Shit. I ain't no hoe and I ain't been.
That's not I wasn't asking any hoes at the tables. None of us hoes are here. There's no hoes at the tables. We are all upstanding adults.
Why do men wife hoes? I mean,
that's what they like.
Hoes is people too, bro.
That's what they like.
Yeah, they just a little more promiscuous than a normal person.
See,
but
my answer to that question would be like, you know, I like people that are living their best, living their humanity to the fullest. Let's experience in other humans. So it might take a lot of humans to experience the full humanity of yourself. But make you less of a person.
Child.
That's your answer?
Where you get that from?
Never mind, that's not my answer no more.
I'm confused. Hey, your face look like my face. He said you need to experience a lot of humans. Hell no.
I said, if you need to. I said, you don't have to, but you're not looking down on if you are.
So why would you wife a hoe then is the question.
If I was the wife of a person that would be deemed a hoe, it wouldn't bother me of her past. I'm trying to be her future and her present.
No, I rock with that.
Okay. And I own that.
That should be all the answers.
I can't want motherfucking Miss Nash.
But she not no hoe no more then.
Yeah, she's
so
hey,
that don't count. Why would you wife one that's currently a whore?
I would not, but like it's nothing to do with me.
But
like,
this is the question you asked.
You want a professional. Professional got experience, correct?
Okay, I guess.
I like experienced professionals in my life.
So this is a real hoe, like. This is a real hoe. This ain't like. This is a real hoe. Yeah.
Like she really like he said bad. He want yeah. one that got a lot of mileage.
I didn't say that.
That's what you just said. Experience. She mastered that profession, huh?
Like.
Man, I guess.
That made it
whatever left. Make you happy.
That made it left.
Sound
that
like something you left. Wanted
to. That was a hard left on that one. All yeah. right.
This next question. I know,
this
all right, guys. We
this
close,
is it. Michael Jackson.
We're going to close our tabs now. So this we can close our tabs. Cognac thoughts. We're done. We're closing that store up. That was the last question.
Hoes. Oh, that was the last question.
Yes, I'm scared
we
to ask
should have traded
more.
That question yeah, in. Yeah, we left off on a bad note.
Do you want another question?
Yeah, but don't leave us off on a bad note.
Do women want money or over? Do women want money over love?
Okay, that's a good one.
Okay, well, there it is.
Okay, I'm gonna say me personally, money does nothing for me. It's a nice perk, but I'm searching for love. Love is it don't go away. It's unconditional. It doesn't. It can't be moved. I want something that's gonna last forever. Not something that's temporary.
The healed me is going to say.
The healed me.
I like that.
No, real shit.
Yeah, I like that.
Like, I've been had experiences where I was down bad.
Amen to that shit.
Like where I fell off and the relationship fell off. But you know what I'm saying? I'm with a woman now who I definitely know she ain't with me for money. You know what I'm saying? So each person, some people in survival mode, bro. Some people want love and they want to be treated right properly. And we gonna figure the money thing out together. And there's some people who I'm in survival mode. What can you do for me? You know what I'm saying? So. Yeah. I ain't no absolutes. There's some women who out for money and there's some women out for love. So, you know what
I'm
saying?
What you're dealing with.
Let me tell you something, though. I don't care what a man or a woman on this earth do. When they find a person that they really, really, really rock with and love, money is never a factor.
Fact.
Ever. I done seen hoes go back to their pimp and leave a man who got money all day because they in love with that man. It don't matter. Love chump money. Some women don't love the man.
That's facts.
I had a question about some love. I don't know where I wrote it at.
It's more men asking women for money now, though. Like, the tables have turned. Really? Yes.
It's nasty.
Yes. Yes. I done been asked for money so many times. So many times. Like, I'm a pocketbook.
I had experience where, like I said, when I was down bad, and my guy used to pay for us to do something. I used to feel horrible. Okay.
Yeah, I keep talking about these restaurants.
I used to feel horrible. I used to be like, man.
Run up out of here.
That's what real men would do. They would feel horrible. But at the same time, don't take that away from her from doing for you because that's what she want to do.
But eventually, it took a toll on the relationship too, though. So, you know what I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? Like, as a man, you want to be able to provide. You want to be able to do everything your woman requires or needs you to do, but you know what I'm saying? Like, but it go back to what you said. Like, if that woman really loves you, she gonna weather the storm and she gonna make sure you come out on top, you come out good. So, you know what I mean? Like, don't know.
Shit, y'all shouldn't be going nowhere if both of us can't fund it somehow.
That's some how way I feel. I was like, I'd rather stay in the crib.
Yeah, but, it'd be like a once a month type thing, but it would never be something that was continuous. To where we going out every day, and I know you ain't, you can't do it, and you making me feel some type of way every, because that's gonna take away your pride.
Yeah, for sure. It did.
So I understand now.
Yeah. So I mean, it go both ways.
Yeah.
Emotion makes you cry sometimes.
Really?
Make you fall. So what you think? Love.
Right, he ain't even answer the question. Yeah,
love is a young man's game. Young person's game. I got old.
This man didn't being hurt because he coming back. It's nothing but negativity, ain't it?
That's not negativity. I'm just saying.
But you know what? He like professional women.
Yeah.
That's not what I said either.
You're going to be hurt.
You're going for the women.
That is not what I said
and
either.
And who won't love you.
This is the problem. That diagnosed my problem. Diagnosing here. The person I used to be is not the person I am now. Okay? I realized that the choices I made then are coming to be consequences now because I don't have bridges to people. Like I don't have like every relationship I have is from me working at building it. I don't have like cousins. I have no like auxiliary relationships. Like dating wise, like once it's over. So there's no spinning the blocks. There's no like I have no connection tissue to no other human beings outside of what I built. I'm the friend that put people on. Like I'm plugged for my friends. My friends don't put me on no different women or societies or cultures or Roombas. Like, all the shit I have is built on what I do, but did I do so much that where when it comes to me and dating, I'm not dealing with a lot of shit. If I feel like you want me, if I feel like you want me to want you more than I want myself, I don't want to be here no more. Like, I don't like feel like we're playing golf, not tennis. I'm just me always pursuing you, and you don't say shit back. I don't have to deal with this.
Oh, yeah. Everybody wants you to.
Same energy.
Reciprocity.
Yeah. I'm not playing no shit like that. I don't know what you see me as. Like, I should do more than what you expect me to do. Like, I'm valuable too, man. I'm like, mm-mm.
So that's what you've been experiencing?
For a long ass time. In all different realms. But what, the last 7 years?
Same. You're not experiencing the same amount of energy being.
It's not
received
balanced.
And given. So, yeah, there's no balance. But what type of women are you going for? Are they women that they, in their mind, they feel like they are. I'm not trying to be shallow or rude or disgusting, but do they feel like they are out of your league and they are just, you know, in the meantime, just entertaining you to get what they want? Because if you're doing too much work, that means they're not interested.
The bigger problem is, like, I'm not in the right rooms with people. Like, I don't have access to rooms where the internet shit, though, it's not even valuable. I don't like to bring it's not, I need to be in real rooms now. Like, and that shit is a wrap for me. Like, I've done it for so long, it's not even a respectable option. I do it as window shopping, but I ain't buying shit. Like, I need to get in different rooms. So, like, I don't have, like, a family of cousins and brothers and sisters. Like, oh, come hang with us. I'm the motherfucking party planner and train station. So, like, I don't have the same, like, let me call up Mark and say, let's go do some shit. I'm calling up a motherfucker and say, let's go do some shit. You know what I'm saying? So, like, my problem is I don't get exposure or different rooms I would like to be involved in. You know what I'm saying? I don't have the same back and forth with my friends. I don't know. I'm in a weird space. I've always been. I've been more of the pioneer than a part of the team. I've been the team. I've been the person. It's new shit. Bring my friends along. Now we are doing some shit. No one ever says, hey, I'm going here. Let me invite you. I've been the inviter, not the invitee.
But at the same time, I only thing I can suggest for you in this day and age is please do try the dating websites, because you can really just eliminate all the bullshit and you can just go for exactly what you want and exactly what they want. When they're coming for you, they already know what they're getting and you already know what you're getting.
You coming from a woman's, I've been on a dating website as a man. Trash.
Why are you serious?
Yeah, like it's like
that shit. I'm not ready to pay. That's the thing. I'm not ready to
You go. Don't have to
no,
pay.
No, as a man, you have to pay to really be in position to really make the most of what you're doing. Like you have to get on the other side of the paywall to really have more control of what you're seeing. Cause you see what might like you, you might not like it, not knowing. Like, she might be a bad one, but you can't see what that is. You assume, oh, yeah, this ain't her. It's not her. Like, it's weird.
I feel like it's
different as a man on that date shit.
Y'all probably, it's probably some high quality men on some of the sites. But I don't feel like a lot of high quality women really run to those sites because they like, it's like a stigma to it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so I can just go out somewhere and nigga hit on me.
Every time I've been on it, it was like, it might be like a few decent looking girls and then like it's some girls selling it. And
I'm like, nah.
Some girls who ain't everywhere. They wasn't born girls.
It get crazy.
Oh. Yeah, like it's a whole nother experience.
Because if
like,
you're bad in real life, you probably don't need to be on the internet. You getting it in real life.
That's facts.
No, because I use the dating website because for one, like you said, I was too busy. Too busy. And then if I do go somewhere, it's like everybody, you know, for the most part, I've seen them before. Never finna do social media as far as like dating anybody off of social media. And I knew that, you know, the more I built my own brand and stuff, it was a lot of people when I went on a date, if they knew of me, they next question after the date was over, so how much do I have to pay for a picture? What? Yeah, so I got tired of hearing it. So in return, I'm like, you know what? I prayed about it. And on December 31st, I said, I'm going to go ahead and try on January 1st. I'm going to jump on a dating website and see how it goes. And I don't know what happened, but it happened. And I accidentally swiped that dude picture. And he said hi. And we've been together ever since. Like, and I don't think he meant to swipe me. I don't think I meant to swipe him. But somehow we met. And I feel like that's my whole soulmate.
Oh, that's good.
So, I mean, you never know, Marcus.
Okay, I've been on dating websites for like 15 years. That's what I can tell you. I've been there since it was MySpace, AIM, Black Planet. I can go through it. I've been there for so long. I ain't never been off the motherfuckers. I've been single all my goddamn life. I had 4 or 6 months where I had a girlfriend. I'm 37. So
when you go, I mean, you can find a woman at the grocery store.
Yeah, see, my real life game is trash. That's the problem. My keyboard game is amazing because I've been there for so long. My outside game is trash, but I should say something, but I don't know what the fuck I'm supposed to say.
Negativity? You're not going into it with a positive light. So you got to first let go of the hurt. And then cut back on your heart because you're heartless right now.
I don't even know if it's the hurt. I feel like it might be a confidence issue then. If you say your real life game is...
I don't know what to say. Like, I think like, what do I say now?
Human being. You say, how you doing?
Then what happens next?
You saying like,
what's your sign?
I'm a Scorpio.
But I should know. What are you?
I'm a Leo.
You saying like you got a good sense of humor and stuff. Women love humor, bro.
Yeah, I'm funny as a motherfucker. I overthink it.
The person you being right now, why can't you just be that person when you meet a woman?
Yeah. You could do the podcast thing and be like, oh, you look so beautiful. I have a podcast show. Would you mind being a guest? We ask these type of questions. It's all type of game out of here. You just got to know how to run it.
And women love a man who, like, in his purpose, too, man. Like, they love to see a dude doing something.
I do enjoy my purpose.
Yeah.
I do enjoy my little podcast.
Yeah, man. So, I would say just be yourself, man. Like, don't overthink it. Like, what they going to say?
I got to underthink.
No. That's the worst thing you can hear is no. Who cares?
Yeah. I mean, you might get cussed out. You might get called a bitch.
I love a good cuss out.
Once they say no, just walk away.
Yeah.
You know, that's it. You
I love I respect. Respect always. I have my feelings, but.
But you're going to have to really step out on faith.
Oh, boy.
You can get it. You hitting 40, and you're going to be setting your way.
Whoa, why we got to say that, though? Why we got to say I'm hitting 40, though? Like,
it's true.
But we don't have to say. A lot of things is true we got to say.
I'm just trying to help you.
I got time. I have time.
That's
I am
what we
time.
All think until the time is gone.
Well, I had a good run.
Ooh.
Use my best pitches then.
You want to be 80 and alone. That's something I don't want to do. That's the only thing I don't want to do is be alone. Ain't nothing like sharing your life with somebody.
But if you never done it, I don't know.
It's a good thing clearly, once you do get it.
Clearly it's something you want, though.
I do. Like, I hate that I want it, because it makes, it fulfills my humanity, and I feel it's something I should embrace and enjoy. But I have a hard time making it make sense.
So, when you wanted to start this podcast, what did you do?
I went for it.
You started it, right?
I started it.
Wow.
So that's well, no, that's I'm lying. No. Cecil invited me in to help him with his podcast, and then I created my own podcast. So it was the invite into the podcast to help him. I found mine.
But you did it, right?
I did it, and I stuck with it. We're here now.
So we giving you advice. So from this advice, take it, run with it, and get your relationship on.
Nashville, I'm on the way. Pack my car.
He finna go straight to the white girl.
That's not what. That's not even what to say.
About going to a country music convention.
Right back to the white girl. I'm like, wait a minute.
All the dollars.
You don't want to go to Memphis. He don't want. But baby down there, they love them big. I tell you one thing. They call me too skinny while I was down there.
Bro, you winning, man. Like, I used to be like a bigger dude. Like, and back when I was big, well, nobody checking for no big dude. For real. Like, that wasn't cool. That wasn't in. Like, beards and bellies is in, bro. Keep growing your beard. You got the belly.
I got Rail was at the pancakes with his girlfriend, the poet. He got some beard stuff. Rail, art by Rail.
Okay, you remember I'm on live, so don't say nothing negative.
No, I'm gonna say I'm not a bad person. I'm gonna say it's bad. Rail, you get my beard together. Talking, hey,
honey, she's very beautiful.
Yeah, honey's amazing. God, they came to the house and did the podcast. There, man, that gave me hope. Then I'm like, well,
because he's just a little plus size. But at the same time, at the same time, he just a little plus side, but he ain't that much plus side. But his girlfriend is very, very tiny, so I guess he's thinking in that manner. But at the same time,
I just love
you can't be shallow. You gotta whatever's attracted to you, you gonna have to find an attraction to them too. Long as she ain't on meth.
Lord.
Just the best thing I can tell you, just be yourself and exude confidence, because a woman know if you scared, bro. Mm-hmm. So if you scared, don't even go talk to her, because they can feel it.
Switch up them Crocs.
You got some Birkenstocks. Okay. I did some Birkenstocks and Berks.
Okay, well, at least they Birkenstocks.
At least some Berks. I wear Berks during the summertime.
At least
they Birkenstocks. Who knew with the Birkenstock top size
15? I know, right? They want all the money.
They're 48s in the it's a European size.
Yeah, they want all the money. All I'm saying is,
they got two pair of these and two
pairs
of Bostons.
You gotta really just open up your mindset. You can get whoever you want to get. You just, like he said, confidence is everything.
Yeah, facts, man. Just go for it. Once you start doing anything, like I'm gonna give myself as an example. Like I started painting shoes, and I've been painting shoes for years. Mm-hmm. Like I said, I just transitioned to paint. I mean to canvas.
Mm-hmm.
Like she told me I should transition to canvas. My barber, he a artist. He been telling me and I was just scared to do it for so long. You know what I'm saying? And I just did it. Happen to be decent at it. And even if I wasn't decent at it, I would just keep doing it till I got decent at it. You know what I'm saying? So that's all I can tell you. Like, keep doing it till you, you know what I'm saying? Like, after a while, you might be walking by, every girl walk by, you might try to talk to her.
Yeah.
If they shut you down, you're just going to be like, okay. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, the most they can say is no.
Yep. Once you learn how to deal with no and don't let it hurt you no more, you can do anything. Just, I'm on
the top. I believe you. I agree. This is my clean out corner. I'm going to say Deonne for coming down to clean out corner and give some great advice.
No one.
Still swinging.
Cut off my mic.
I thank Ricardo for coming down to Kanye Corner and I give these dropping these gems out here.
Appreciate y'all for having me too.
Let me have my black ass soul. Find me. I said, Mama, I got to a 40. Find me a good black woman. If I don't, well, I gave him a dime.
Get you one of these foreigners who need a green card. Have one tomorrow.
I'm not going for that. I read books.
Have one tomorrow. You hear me?
I'm not going for that. Ricardo, where can we find you at? Get some shit customized and painted.
I'm on Facebook, Ricardo Feetby Swait. Instagram, Feetby Swait, FeetbySwait. And I'm on TikTok too. And yeah, just follow me and hit me up. I got you.
Deonne, where can we find you? Close your tab out.
Same. Instagram, Art by Deonne. And Facebook, Your Neighborhood Artist. Or just Google Your Neighborhood Artist.
Close my tab. Everybody is somebody because of somebody else. Once again, everybody is somebody because of somebody else. Don't be mad at the truth. Don't be mad at the lie that made you comfortable. But they hating you, they missing themselves. Trust is lost in buckets, the gain in drops. Growth scares people that don't want to change. Aspire to inspire before you expire. One more time. For the niggas in the bag. Aspire to inspire before you expire. Love yourself, love each other, and love is all we got.